If you've ever been shopping for an LED light panel, a monitor, or even a light bulb, and found yourself confused or annoyed at the various units there are for measuring the intensity of those products, like nits, lux, and lumens, then I've got a video for you. Let's get undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
Wise up. I'm Gerald Undone, and today we're talking about units for measuring light. Now, I'm going to try and avoid some of the more complicated physics that would typically accompany this topic, because my goal is for you to be able to memorize some of the basics of this guide and then use that when making purchase decisions, and I don't think that's really going to work if I bog this video down with too much math. So if there's any pedantic physicists watching, consider yourself disclaimed. Alright, so let's start off with the units that we're going to be focusing on. First, we've got the light bulb, which is typically advertised using watts or lumens. Then we've got light panels, which deal with lux, and then we've got display screens, like in your phone, computer monitor, or Atomos recorder, which use nits. So let's start off with watts, because they don't really belong. The watt is a unit of power, or more practically, a unit of how much electricity you're consuming over a period of time. It's also a unit of radiant flux, which is how much radiometric power is being emitted by a source, which also relates to light bulbs. But since radiant flux doesn't indicate the power of just the visible light, it's not that useful to us for this video. So instead, think of watts as how much that light is going to cost you to run, or how big of a battery you'll need to power it. Now, if all the light bulbs were using the same filament or technology, then the watt might actually give you a decent indication of how bright they'd seem, since more power should mean more output. And in that case, I suppose the watt would be somewhat doubly useful, but not so much today, because a 14-watt incandescent bulb is not going to give you similar light emittance to a 14-watt LED. But it's still useful in knowing that both of those bulbs would require 14 watts when it comes to paying the electricity bill. So the better way to measure light bulbs is with lumens, because it's consistently practical even when you change the technology inside the bulb or its power requirements. Unlike radiant flux, the lumen is a unit of luminous flux. And when we say flux, by the way, just think of something flowing. It's a way of describing the perception that an effect appears to be moving across or through a surface. And so a lumen is the quantity of visible light emitted by a source. And the word visible is important here because this unit is weighted toward the human eye's capabilities. Now, when we talk about lumens, we're really talking about candela, which are the base units used to measure luminous intensity and are roughly equal to the light emitted from one wax candle. And just like with light bulbs and watts, candles also have radiant intensity, but we discount the wavelengths that aren't important to the human eye, and what we're left with is luminous intensity. And because this intensity has to be measured perceptually visibly by the human eye, we measure it in a solid angle and in a specific direction. But lumens aren't limited to that specific direction and angle, and instead cover the entire sphere of radiation. So if a light is able to emit one candela in all directions uniformly, it has a total luminous flux of 12.57 lumens. And so if you take this LED bulb here, which has a rating of 1500 lumens, that's like saying it has a similar intensity to 120 wax candles emitting their light uniformly in all directions. 1500 divided by 12.57 is about 120 candles, rounded. Now hopefully you're still with me, because it's going to get a whole lot easier from here out now that we've established our basic units. So that's all great for light bulbs, but what if you buy an LED panel? They usually have a rating of a certain amount of lux at a specified distance. For instance, this LED panel here has a rating of 1500 lux at 1 meter. As I was saying, it gets easier now, because as a lumen is a measure of luminous flux, a lux is a measure of luminous flux in an area. So remember how I said that lumens are like candles emitting their light uniformly in all directions? Well, I didn't say how far, because lumens don't really care about distance, but lux do. Think of lumens as how much light is being emitted regardless of where you are, luminous flux. But then think of lux as how much of that light is hitting your face, illuminance, how illuminated you are. And so a lux is equal to one lumen per square meter, essentially how well illuminated that specific distance is. And we use lux for light panels for two reasons. One, we're likely lighting a subject, so we need to understand how distance is going to impact our lighting. And two, because LED panels have beam angles, and if you're trying to describe how many lumens are in a specific area, the beam angle is important. If the beam angle is wider, even if the lumens are the same, the amount of light radiating from your source, the light will be less intense on your subject, therefore your subject will have less illuminance or be less illuminated. A light with a more narrow beam angle will have a higher lux at the same distance, because the lumens will be more focused and thus will illuminate the subject better. Now, if you're trying to light your subject with light bulbs, they don't have a set beam angle because they radiate in all directions, which is why we measure them in lumens. But there is a formula you can use for converting the lumens of a light bulb into lux to give you a better sense of how it will compare to an LED panel when it comes to illuminating your subject. But as I said, I will avoid the math in this video, so I'll put a link to a calculator you can use to convert the lumens to lux in the description instead. You can also use it the other way, to calculate the lumens of your panels based on their lux and their beam angles provided by the manufacturer. So if we put this light bulb into the calculator with an angle of 180 degrees, because that's as wide as it can possibly be when you're viewing it from one side, even though it's 360 degrees total, and then we put in 1 meter, again we're going to do it at 1 meter, and this light bulb is 1500 lumens, and hit calculate lux, it tells us that this light bulb will give us 240 lux when 1 meter away. And this type of information can be useful when comparing LED panels to light bulb kits. Now there's another unit that covers a similar idea to this, but it isn't SI standard, and it's called the foot candle. It also attempts to provide distance to the candela and quantify illuminance, but at a rate of one candle 1 foot away, hence foot candle. Now I find this unit to be wonky, and luckily you probably won't encounter it on any lighting products related to photo and video, but the conversion would be 10.764 lux for every foot candle, in case you encounter it. Now LED panels also have ratings in watts, but again, this is more useful for power consumption and battery pairings than it is for illuminance, as that power is subject to the efficiency of the panel circuitry and not the perceived output of light. Okay, so we've talked about luminous flux, which is the perceived power of a light, and illuminance, which is the light incident on a surface. Now we need to talk about luminance, which is the amount of light emitted or reflected from an area. And this is where your phone screens and monitors come in. This is also where the term brightness is more applicable, and thus why the control to increase the output of your screens is called brightness. Remember how we said that brightness is the quality of how light will be received by your eye? Well, luminance is how much luminous flux will be detected by an eye from a particular angle of view, or simply, how bright a surface will appear. And you know that the angle of view is important, because if you've ever looked at a monitor from off to the side, you'll know that it's not nearly as intense as when you look at it straight on. And this brightness is measured in candela per square meter, but it's also known as nits. Essentially, if you were to look at a screen and detect 250 candles of luminous power at a specific angle, you would say that it's emitting 250 nits. And 250 nits, by the way, happens to be about the peak luminance of a typical LCD panel, but HDR displays and phones can go well beyond that. The Atomos Ninja 5, for example, is capable of 1,000 nits. Now, luminance isn't restricted to just screens, but rather anything that is illuminated can also have a luminance value. So for example, if I take this LED panel and shine it at my desk, it will illuminate a portion of my desk and will measure that illumination in lux. But when I examine that illuminated section on my desk, the brightness of its reflection is its luminance, and we measure that in nits, or candela per square meter. And this can keep going back and forth, because that reflection might then illuminate my face, and that illumination will be measured in lux. But then my face will be brighter, and that brightness as it's perceived to you will be my luminance and will be measured in nits. And this is true for things that don't have screens as well. For example, if you were to look up at a cloudy, overcast sky at midday, the brightness of that sky might measure 2,000 nits. That's just how bright the sky looks to your eye. But if you were to use that same overcast sky to illuminate a subject that you wanted to photograph, it might have an equivalent illuminating power of 1 to 2,000 lux on your subject, depending on the clouds. Fun fact, if however you were to look at the sun through a clear sky at midday, you'd be staring at about 1.6 billion nits, and that's well beyond what your eyes can withstand. Now there is another unit used in photographic lighting, and that's the guide number found on strobes and speed lights, but it is quite a bit different than the types of units we've been discussing today, so I think I'll make a separate video about that and conclude this one here. A lux is a measure of that luminous flux in an area. Lux, flux, luminous flux, it sounds funny. It's intensity of those products like Nits, LUTs, and Wahazap. At the various units there are for measuring the intensity of those products, like licks, nuts, and licks and nuts. Okay. Wahazap. So if there's any pedantic physicists, something like a bumblebee. As always, I hope you found this video helpful or at least entertaining, and if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, feel free to hit the dislike button twice. Narrate! I'm done.